down the steep incline through Yazoo, under a canopy of pear trees flowering in the first breath of spring, past the crumbling Victorian homes, the shotgun houses and bait shops reclaimed by kudzu, into the flatlands of the Delta. Rows of tilled rich soil roll by like the shadow of a tall man walking in the late afternoon sun. Fields of lilac as far as the eye can see. A lone shack rots in the shade of an old oak tree. A shell of a factory. An abandoned school. Like ships lost at sea, slowly giving way to time. Relics of a culture that once was.
Creek and robbed the bank, I think it's right there. At least that's the way we tell the story.
This place is full of ghosts. Memories, half-forgotten stories. Places people used to live.
Do you realize that the house on the right one is where Meemaw grew up?
It was really a totally different place. It's just all kind of nothing here anymore. And there was a little drugstore, the Marion Parlor, and you would go in and have some ice cream after you went to the movies.
Mom taught me how to ride horses, and she was an artist, and she did oil paintings, and she planted strawberries, and she was just a really neat person. She was still riding horses when she was in her 70s.
Where did she live?
Right there on Arnold Avenue, right across the street from my piano teacher. Lou Pryor was one of Granddaddy Farr's best friends, and he married Hattie Pryor, and they're the ones that knew Hemingway and Lauren Bacall, and Lauren Bacall tried to take Larry away from Hattie. He was like maybe 10 years younger than Hattie, and she wouldn't let Lauren Bacall have him. So here's his house right here. My mother grew up here, and her mother. There were dances and children and trips to the sea. There were bowls brought back from foreign lands, clocks collected and carefully hung on walls of walnut. There were photographs in silver handed down from generation to generation. A statue erected in the garden where three dogs were buried, one by one. And there were books. Oh, there were books. Have to acclimatize yourself. You have to sit outside for a little while and let the outside come in. And then you can
go in there and get to work.
Where did all the years go? Empty cross and broken torn. Chest of drawers won't work anymore. Spent the time to make it nice. Don't forget the best.
I wonder if I should take this though to camp.
This was your grandmother's cake. She would make buttermilk cake and bring it to Uncle Barry and all this. But you want to throw it away. Your heritage, your family heritage. I'm throwing it away.
This is Glenn Livett. I'm corpse rotten. Why would he have all this brandy?
People in the Delta used to drink brandy. Like, I was taught to drink brandy when I was 16.
Brandy. I think we're just going to throw it all away. Puerto Rican rum. All these corks are rotten. Some of this liquor is probably 60 or 70 years old. Here's a little flask.
Cleaning out somebody else's house really changes. Approach things in life. You find out you don't need a lot of things.
I'm sorry some of the stuff got a little wet.
Oh, that's okay. I was in there cooking some food on a cooker because I don't have a stove yet, but I'll be getting my stove and stuff. It doesn't matter where they sit it because I am just so appreciated right now.
So much, I swear.
I really needed it.
On that chair.
So no, I appreciate it. I swear I could just cry right about now.
Empty house, broken home. She'll move out, you'll be all
pieces of lives, fragments of a bygone era, reminders of youth and beauty long lost, moments buried by the constant march of time.
When all the years go,
time frozen against the thought.
I said, where did all the years go? Where did they go?
The things that define us slip away, and all that's left is the memory. You are dust, and to dust you shall return. Your daughter will give away your books, and your granddaughter will pour wine on your grave as she remembers you fondly. Your house will be sold, and spring will come, and the pear trees will bloom, and the river will keep rolling on.